Day in a row, AT&T is refusing to adequately explain what caused Volusia County's 911 system to become unreliable for hours yesterday. WESH News investigative reporter Matt Grant spoke with a Volusia County leader today who is not happy about AT&T's response or lack thereof, Matt.
Well, Martha, one councilman tells me AT&T's contract with the county could come to an end if they don't provide the public with answers.
What's going on?
I'm going crazy. I don't know what happened.
On the same day, police say an armed robber tied up a man and a woman, stole their car, and died after a shootout with cops on I-95. Volusia County's 911 system was getting spotty service, and not every call was going through.
This is dire. This is an emergency. This is all people have. Older people.
WESH 2 News covered the outage yesterday, documenting the 911 service was intermittent for 8 hours. According to the Volusia County Sheriff's Office, the company described the problem as a trunk group failure. But when WESH 2 News investigates asked AT&T about that,
don't you owe the public an explanation about what happened?
A spokeswoman refused to go on camera for the second day in a row, saying the issue was, quote, too complicated to explain to you.
With all due respect, isn't that your job?
Orange and Lake counties both say they've never had problems with their 911 system. The 911 coordinator for Lake County says they have redundancies in place to make sure something like this doesn't happen, but say it appears AT&T either did not have a failsafe in place or it was not working.
What's the backup? What's the safeguard that's in place?
That's the problem. I don't think there was.
Councilman Josh Wagner says nobody from AT&T has contacted him or explained what went wrong. He says if the problems aren't corrected, this could cost them their taxpayer-funded contract.
It's unacceptable. The question is, does it rise to the level of discontinuing the service?
The county rerouted 911 calls to another phone line. They say that line did not receive any calls yesterday. Late today, AT&T did send me a two-line statement. They say there were no issues for their customers calling 911, and the problem was a cable cut to another provider's network that caused phone issues for their customers. Back to you.
Matt, thanks. Melbourne